Hello everyone. As you know, my name is Arun. I'm a professor of management, an athlete and an artist. Also a memory athlete beyond the names of countries and capitals and stuff like that. And I came across the US president's list. And there are 46 presidents, as you would be aware. So I thought, is it possible for us to memorize that in some manner? So we can start. Imagine you get up in the morning and the first thing that you recall is you got to wash a ton of clothes. Perfect. That's your first US president. Washing ton. So once you washed a ton of clothes, you're hungry. It's natural. You pick up an apple. Remember the Adam's apple? So the name of the second president was John Adam. So don't worry. If you get the name Adam, that is more than enough at this stage. Then, having done that, you remember, you got to write a ton of assignments for your submissions. A lot of homework that you have, it could be a project. So that reminds you of the third US president. And you're like, I'm not his son, how can I write so much? Because the third president actually wrote the Declaration of Independence. And the hint is, I'm not his son, it's like Jefferson. You got it? Then let's go ahead. Once you're writing and writing, you're actually mad. So the weirder the imagination, the better you will remember. So you thought, mad. I'm not Jefferson's son. So I'm Madison. Okay? It's like Madison. So once you like mad about this, you're Madison. The next one is, you now like thinking, how beautiful if I could go on this Monday morning and I could go rowing. Okay? Rowing on a lake. So we pick Mon from Monday and we pick Row from rowing. We put them together. That's the fifth president, Monroe. So once you have this, now we come to the next step. Obviously, when you are rowing hard, it's a tough work. And then, unfortunately, you just have another apple. Remember the second name, John Adams? Again, we have John Adams. But this apple, you just imagine it is from Queens, New Zealand. Okay? So the name in between that is Quincy. John Quincy Adams. Now, while you're enjoying your apple, you see two troublemakers walking towards a van. And you recognize them as Jack and his son. So the next name is Jackson. Where are they walking? They're walking towards a van. What do they want to do? They want to burn it. Van Buren. So the next name of the president is Van Buren. So once you see what they're up to, you're like hurrying to save the van. Hurrying is Harrison. Okay? Now comes a weird imagination. As you're hurrying to save the van, you happen to look down and you're wearing a tie for some reason. So the next name is Tyler. T-Y-L-E-R is Tyler. And it has polka dots, the Russian polka dots. Next name of the president is Polk. So once you get there, the Polk, you also happen to look at your dress and you're thinking, I need a new tailor. So the next president is Taylor. T-A-Y-L-O-R. Okay, and these are the thoughts which are in your mind as you're going to save the van. Okay, now you pick up a pail of water and you want to fill it more. So the next president's name is Phil Moore. Alright, but then you notice as you're taking the water towards the van, it's leaking. That means the bucket has been pierced by something. So the next name of the president is Pierce. So anyway, you actually save the van by throwing water on the van, on the burning van. And you kind of rescue a book. So the next president's name is Buchanan. And when you are looking at the book, it's a book of the 16th president of United States, Abraham Lincoln. So that's quite a treasure. So you turn it around, you want to see who published this book, and you notice John and Sons. So the next president is Johnson. So then you figure out that, okay, Johnson must have got a large amount of money, which is also called a grant from a university to publish this book. So the next name of the president is Grant. All right. With this grant, what did the publishers do? They bought a farm, and the farm has a lot of hay in it. So the next name of the president is Hayes. H-A-Y-E-S. Hayes. Okay. So you went to the farm. You're standing in front of the hay, and you notice a cartoon character on top of the hay, and that's our Garfield. So the next name of the president is Garfield. Now what happens is, Garfield says two surprising things. He says, I am the author of the book. So instead of author, the next name of the president is Arthur. A-U-R-T-H. Okay? Or Arthur. Arthur. Alright. And then what happens is, he says, do you know, Garfield says, do you know, my name is Cleve, and this is my land. So the next name of the president is Cleveland. And Garfield tells you, get out of my land. So you're like hurrying again to get off his land. So here comes Harrison again. You remember, we already talked about one Harrison. This Harrison, which is Benjamin Harrison, is the grandson of that Harrison, which I spoke a couple of names ago. Okay. So the moment you're out of the farm, Garfield calls you, come back to Cleveland. That's the same Cleveland which gets repeated again. Okay. But you know more to go. Now you want to have water. You know the popular brand of water is Kinley. So the next name of the president is McKinley. So once you're there, what happens is, you had a lot of water, and suddenly you realize you've been working hard since morning. You've been rowing, you've been washing a ton of clothes, you've been doing so many things, and you notice that the loose belt, you have a situation of the loose belt. So the name of the president is Roosevelt. Okay. Now, with your loose belt, you're walking, you come across a seashore, you find a beautiful raft. So the name of the next president is Taft. Okay. And by the way, his name is William Howard Taft. So as you're admiring that, the captain of the raft, we're imagining there is a captain of the raft, you're asking him some questions. You're saying, this is made of wood. He says, yes. So the name of the next president is Woodrow. And in fact, it is Woodrow Wilson. Okay. You ask him, is the metal that holds the wood together, is it tough? He says, yeah, we made it hard by first heating it and then cooling it. Okay. So the word is hard, is hardening. And then he says, we cooled it down. So coolage. And by the way, the unit of temperature is Kelvin, but here the name starts, Kelvin starts with C, Kelvin Coolidge. Okay, now we've cooled it down. So he says, we are ready to go, let me just vacuum clean my raft. So the most famous brand of vacuum cleaners in the world is Hoover. So the name of the next president is Hoover. Alright, so once he has vacuum cleaned, he happens to look at your loose belt. He says, but we have a situation here. He says, frankly, there is a situation of the loose belt. So the name of the next president is Franklin D. Roosevelt. Okay, so he says, I can't take you there. And obviously he is speaking the truth. He is true. So he is a true man. That's the name of the next president. True man. Okay. If somebody doesn't speak the truth, well, we can punish him or her by putting some ice inside, right? Till the person howls. So ice howls is Eisenhower. Okay. Remember one thing. All of these imaginations better be weird. The more the weird they are, the better you go to remember it. Alright, so weirder is better. So the name was Eisenhower. And the person says, there'll be so much ice and you'll be howling. You'll feel like an ice candy. Candy is Kennedy. That's the next US president on the list. Kennedy. Okay. And he says you're going to feel absolutely like freezing London. Okay. And the name is Lyndon Johnson. So don't worry about Johnson as long as you get Lyndon. Now, when you have a freezing weather in London, you do nothing. Nothing is also called Nix. So the name of the next US president is Richard Nixon. So Nix tells us Nixon. Okay? Alright. So when you have nothing to do, you want to go for a ride. So you go rent a Ford. Go rent Ford is Gerald Ford. Okay, so now you've rented a Ford and you started driving. Suddenly there is a crater on the road. It's a small crater, but it's a crater on the road. Alright, so the name of the next president is Carter, Jimmy Carter. Okay, now you're stuck there, you're looking here and there, but fortunately for you, when you glance on, let's say, your left side, you find Ronaldo is playing football. And you're like, wow, I get to see Ronaldo. So we'll take Ronald from his name and the name of the next president becomes Ronald Reagan. Okay. And then you ask him, I'm stuck, there is a crater. He says, see the hill, there's a lot of bush there. Okay, so take the bush and put it in the crater and maybe you can still go. Because you can't lift the rocks. So Bush, the name of the next president is George H.W. Bush. H.W. is like homework. Okay, everybody does homework. So George H.W. Bush. And he says, climb up the hill and get a ton of it. Okay, climb ton, Clinton. And what are you supposed to get? Bush. So it is Bush again. So George H.W. Bush's son, his name was George W. Bush. Okay, so who's next in this list? So after George Bush, it is, we said Clinton, we said George W. Bush. Then you look at the other side of the road and it is called Obama Ranch. Okay, so the name is Obama. That's the next president on the list is Obama. Okay, so you go to Obama's ranch, you have something, you refresh yourself, come back. You're tired, so you sit down on a tree stump. Okay, a cut tree. A tree has been cut, so there is a stump. And we remember the next list, name on the list is President Trump. Okay, and you're sitting there and now you're waiting for somebody to come and pick you up. So you're just biding your time. So the name of the next president is Biden and he's the current president.